Swedish, unfortunately, obviously Sam gets a lot of attention, not just in Sweden, but around the world. We'll also not do this in Dutch, so I can personally do this. So we'll do this in English. What's going to happen now is that we will start with a few things. Jan Johansson, CEO of Sam, and Victor Muller, CEO of Spijker Cars. This will be followed by a short Q&A, about 15 minutes, and then we'll have an opportunity for you to take some pictures outside of the Café Opera. Then we'll go back in and we'll facilitate all the individual interviews. Please shut off your mobile phones if that's possible. And then with that, I think I would like to hand over to Jan of Jong.
All right, thank you very much for coming, and we're of course happy to see so many of you here. As you know, this has been a pretty turbulent time for Saab, for our employees, for our dealers, for our suppliers, and of course also for our customers. Ever since December of 2008, when GM placed Saab on the strategic review, the speculations have been many as to the future of Saab, and I'm happy now that we have come to a point where we have secured the future for Saab, as we have signed a binding agreement with the new owner, and we have a final business plan going forward. This is of course something that is a tremendous achievement, where all of us that have been working on this are of course extremely happy about that. And now is really the time to look into the future and make sure that we take this opportunity and develop Saab as an excellent brand also for the future. During this intense speculation phase, and we have of course as a brand been challenged many, many times, but I have to say that the strength of the brand I think has been demonstrated many, many times during this period of time. To forget the recent statements that have been made by many of our customers, many of our people that really have a soft spot for Saab in their heart. And I think this has, of course, made us be very confident that the future for Saab is bright, provided that we sort out the ownership structure as well as the finances for the company going forward. We have had the opportunity during this time to also continue to develop our new cars. And as you know, the new 95 is ready for launch within short. And that means that we will have the possibility to have a fresh start with fresh products that also will generate, of course, a lot of income for the company, but also really over time stabilize Saab, make Saab profitable in the European premium segment. I have had the opportunity, I would say, to be a part of this process already from the beginning. And I must say that I'm very happy now to see Spijker as the new owner for Saab. I've said many times that at this point for Saab, to be a part of a smaller organization is something that we can have a great, great benefit from. Spijker with their, not only with their entrepreneurial view, their enthusiasm, but also their know-how is going to be an asset for Saab going into the future. We have now a very intense work ahead of us, not only to actually sort out some of the open issues. We need to exit the liquidation. We need to restart the business, in particular, get going on the manufacturing side, the distribution process, launch the new 95, as well as ensure that we continue to take care of the brand and develop new products that are the right products, not only for Saab, but also for the European premium segment. I would like to take this opportunity, of course, to thank everybody that has supported us during this period of time, in particular, of course, our employees, our dealers, our suppliers, our customers, and actually everybody that has a soft spot for Saab. Without that, I don't think we would have been where we are at this point. So I'd like to express my personal thanks to all of those who have supported us. With that, I'd like to hand it over to Victor Müller, who is the CEO of Spiker Park, to also make some remarks. Victor?